Test, test.
That's it.
Okay. So when I want to talk. That says the high in love to one who inhabits eternity, whose name is holy. I dwell in the high and holy place, and also with the one who has a contrite and humble spirit, to revive the spirit of the humble, and to revive the heart of the contrite. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. We, most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us. Delight in your will.
Walk in your ways, the glory of your name.
Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on us. forgive us our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen. Amen. Lord, open our lips.
And our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and forever. Amen. You may be seated. And we will say the Venite together on page 4 and 5. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout the joy of the rock of salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. And let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God.
Now
the you have hearkened your voice.
The psalm appointed for this morning is Psalm 26. You'll find that in your Book of Common Prayer on page 616. We read the psalm responsibly by the full verse. Give judgment for me, O Lord, for I have lived with integrity. I have trusted in the Lord and have not faltered.
Test me, O Lord, and try me. Examine my heart and my mind.
For your love is before my eyes. I have walked faithfully with you.
I have not sat with the worthless, nor do I consort with the deceitful.
I have hated the company of evildoers. I will not sit down with the wicked.
I will wash my hands in innocence, O Lord, that I may go in procession round your altar.
Singing aloud a song of thanksgiving and recounting all your wonderful deeds.
Lord, I love the house in which you dwell, in the place where your glory abides.
Do not sweep me away with the sinners, nor my life with those who thirst for blood.
Whose hands are full of evil plots, and their right hand full of bribes.
As for me, I will live with integrity. Redeem me, O Lord, and have pity on me. Glory
to the Father, and to the Son,
and
to
the
Holy
Spirit,
as it was in the beginning,
is now,
and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Job. There was once a man in the land of Uz, whose name was Job. That man was blameless and upright, one who feared God and turned away from evil. One day, the heavenly beings came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan also came among them to present himself before the Lord. The Lord said to Satan, "Where have you come from?" Satan answered the Lord, "From going to and fro on the earth, and from walking up and down on it." The Lord said to Satan, "Have you considered my servant Job? There is no one like him on the earth, a blameless and upright man who feared God and turned away from evil. He still persists in his integrity, although you incited me against him to destroy him for no reason. Then Satan answered the Lord, skin for skin. All that people have, they will give to save their lives. But stretch out your hand now and touch his bones and his flesh, and he will curse you to your face. The Lord said to Satan, very well, he is in your power. Only spare his life. So Satan went out from the presence of the Lord and inflicted loathsome sores on Job, from the sole of his foot to the crown of his head. Job took a posture with which to escape himself and sat among the ashes. Then his wife said to him, do you still persist in your integrity? Curse God and die. But he said to her, you speak as a foolish woman would speak. Shall we receive the good at the hand of God and not receive the bad? In all this, Job did not sin with his lips. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God. We will read the canticle on page 10 all together. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
A reading from the book of Hebrews. Long ago, God spoke to our ancestors in many and various ways by the prophets. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by a son, whom he appointed heir of all things, through whom he also created the worlds. He is the reflection of God's glory and the exact imprint of God's very being. And he sustained all things by his powerful words. When he had made purification for sin, he sat down at the right hand of the Majesty on high. Having become as much superior to angels as the name he has inherited is most excellent than theirs. Now God did not subject the coming world, about which we are speaking, to angels, but someone has testified somewhere. What are human beings that you are mindful of them? Or mortals that you care for them. You have made them for a little while lower than the angels. You have crowned them with glory and honor, subjecting all things under their feet. Now, in subjecting all things to them, God left nothing outside their control. As it is, we do not yet see everything in subjection to them. But we do see Jesus, who for a little while was more lower than the angels, now crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God, he might taste death for everyone. It was fitting that God, for whom and through whom all things exist, in bringing many children to glory, shall make the pioneers of their salvation perfect through sufferings. For the one who sanctified and those who are sanctified all have one Father. For this reason, Jesus is not ashamed to call them brothers and sisters, saying, I will proclaim your name to my brothers and sisters. In the midst of the congregation, I will praise you. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
We will read together the Song of Zechariah on page 13. in your bulletins. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. He promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us, to show mercy to our fathers, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies.
Free to worship him without fear.
Holy and righteous is his sight, all the days of our life.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High. For you will go
before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation. In the tender compassion of the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in the darkness and the shadow of death. The third reading is from the book of Mark. Some Pharisees came, and to test Jesus they asked, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife?" He answered them, "What did Moses command you?" They said, "Moses allowed a man to write a certificate of dismissal and to divorce her." But Jesus said to them, "Because of your hardness of heart, he wrote this commandment for you. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate." Then in the house, the disciples ask again about this matter. He said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery. People are bringing little children to him in order that he might touch them." And the disciples spoke sternly to them. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the little children come to me. Do not stop them. For it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly, I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it." And he took them up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and blessed them. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O God, our strength and our Redeemer.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, good morning. I feel blessed, privileged, and with great humility as I stand before you today in this beloved community that is St. Andrew and Holy Communion. In the third reading from the book of Mark, we learned that people were bringing little children to Jesus so that he may lay hands on them, bless them, and heal whatever ailed them. His disciples, however, not astute and lacking comprehension, rebuked the people sternly because they thought it was the right thing to do. Jesus, seeing what his disciples were doing, became incensed and demanded the children to come to him. Do not hinder them, for it is such as these that the kingdom belongs. Whoever does not receive the kingdom as a little child will never enter it. He took the children up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and blessed them. Jesus is saying, think of the characters of little children. They have childlike faith. They are innocent and have purity of heart, humble and teachable. In Matthew 18, it says, whoever humbles himself like a child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven, end quote. No matter how young or old, selfish or prideful, Jesus receives us just as we are, as long as we come with humble heart, ask the Lord to forgive us and help us. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. Over the course of Jesus' ministry, he often presented children as an example of the type of faith adults ought to have. My brothers and sisters in this beloved community of St. Andrew and Holy Communion, we are never too old to learn and to change. Just as children rely on their parents for their daily needs, we too should humbly depend on our Heavenly Father for both our spiritual and physical realms. We need to examine our posture, take inventory of our relationships, not only with Christ, but with one another. Do not hold grudges. Do not be envious of our brothers and sisters. Do not be spiteful. It's okay to say we are sorry for the wrongs that we may have caused. For some of us, it's difficult to apologize. We don't always have to win. It takes a strong person to shed the pride and the ego for nothing else but peace. Look at Christ Jesus, who is a wonderful example of forgiveness. As we think of Jesus on the cross in the midst of two criminals, he himself did nothing wrong. He was mocked, spat on, beaten, and nailed to the cross for our sins. Even on the cross, he said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they are doing." What a great portrayal of love and forgiveness. I remember many years back, I was upset with my daughter on my way to work one morning because of the infraction that she had done. And I was gone for maybe 8-9 hours. When I arrived home that evening, I was still upset with her. She tried to dialogue with me, but I ignored her. That's holding on to a grudge. She said, "Mom, what's wrong with you?" And I told her that I was holding on to a grudge that had occurred that morning with her. She was stunned. She was amazed and disappointed that I displayed such a behavior. She was right. And I became disappointed in myself. And of course, I was embarrassed. Over the years, I have had opportunities to reflect. I realize that I am still learning to humble myself and let go of my pride. It's definitely not easy. What I have learned in the past 3 years is that life is way too short. I have lost too many loved ones near and dear to my heart. Just look around in this room and on Zoom. There are so many brothers and sisters that are no longer with us. I'm sure some of us would have loved the opportunity to impart a kind word, a warm embrace, or even to say, "I am sorry." God knows the heart of man, and I want to continue to change because this walk with Christ is forever changing us, and it will always be. My brothers and sisters, in this very room, there's quite enough love for all of us. And in this very room, there's quite enough hope for all of us. And in this very room, there is quite enough love for all the world. For Jesus, Lord Jesus, is in this very room. Amen. Thank you. Amen. Let's stand and say the Apostles' Creed together. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into heaven. The day he rose again in accordance
with the right hand of the Father. He will come again and judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord. Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For we need you and we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving help among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hopes of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you're always more ready to hear than we to pray, and to give more than we either desire or deserve. Pour upon us the abundance of your mercy, forgiving us those things of which our conscience is afraid, and giving us those good things for which we are not worthy to ask, except through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
O God, the King Eternal, whose light divides the day from the night and turns the shadow of death into the morning, drive far from us all wrong desires. Incline our hearts to keep your law, and guide our feet into the way of peace, that, having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, when night comes, rejoice to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you is eternal life, and to serve you is perfect freedom. defend us, your humble servants, in all assaults of your enemies, that we, surely trusting in your defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers, which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you, through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Please be seated.
These are the prayers of the people. Form 6, which you may find in your Book of Common Prayer on page 392, or in our bulletin on page 13. In peace we pray to you, Lord God, for all people in their daily life and work,
for our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone,
for this community, the nation, and the world,
for all who work for justice, freedom, and peace,
for the just and proper use of your creation,
for the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression,
for all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble,
for those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy,
for the peace and unity of the Church of God,
for all who proclaim the gospel and who seek the truth,
for Michael, our presiding bishop, and Carly, our bishop, and for all bishops and other ministers, for the special needs and concerns of this congregation, prayers for all those overcoming the effects of COVID and its variants. I ask your prayers for Paul Tunick and Susie Kiger, Pat Butler, for Larry and Dana Schwartz, and for Lynette Reed, and for Janet and Patricia Hart, for Lolu, Randy, and Akani, for Jerry Spanarkle and Allie Kennedy. Are there any persons traveling in the week? We'll have a prayer for travelers then. O God, whose glory fills the whole creation, and whose presence we find wherever we go, preserve those who travel, in particular all who are risking their lives by traveling to work during this pandemic. Surround them with your loving care. Protect them from every danger. Bring them in safety to their journey's end. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear us, Lord, for your mercy is great. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life, for this new day added to our lives, for our health, our friends and family, for God's protection upon us.
Prayer of thanks for the ministry of joy and Manesse.
Mm-hmm.
Start with this morning.
Amen. Are there any persons having birthdays this week or soon? Yes. Okay. Well, we'll have a prayer for birthdays then. Pardon me, honey? Oh, really? Okay, that's good. How about that? Cool. So this is a prayer for birthdays then, for all over. Watch over your children, O Lord, as their days increase. Bless and guide them wherever they may be. Strengthen them when they stand. Comfort them when discouraged or sorrowful. Raise them up if they fall. In their hearts, may your peace, which passes all understanding, abide all the days of their life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Are there any couples celebrating anniversaries at this time? Mm-hmm. We'll have a prayer for anniversaries then. Yes. I'm sorry. Yes. Good. Okay, good. Joey and Carrie? Okay. Kathy? Was Tara and whom? All right. Then Joey and Kara. Carrie? All right. Let's have a prayer then. Gracious God, remember with great thanksgiving the vows of love and commitment to you and to each other, made by these persons, Carrie and Mike and Tara. But before us this day, we pray for your continued blessing. We pray that they may learn from both their joys and their sorrows and discover constantly new rich in their life together in you. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. We will exalt you, O God, our King. Praise your name forever and ever. We pray for all who have died that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. I ask your prayers for Bill Bradbury, who died a year ago this week, and for victims of violence and stupidity, for accidents. Yes, COVID. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them who put their trust in you.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Announcements.
Myself in it. See, I talk about my daughter, who, you know, I'm working on it.
Oh, yeah.
Good morning, ultimate mom.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring it back in for the announcements.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for being here. And let's welcome Joanna and Carrie, who's worshiping with us, and their family. You want to stand up? Okay. Welcome, and feel free to join us at any other time. We're pleased to have you in our presence. Okay. And let us give a big round of applause to our own Joy Manasse, who worshiped, preached, celebrated, and inspired us this morning. Congratulations and thank you, Joy. The announcements in the bulletin are pretty self-explanatory. We know Reverend Rose is away on vacation for this week. Well-deserved vacation, so let's keep her and her family in our prayers for a safe and happy vacation. The announcements are very self-explanatory. They don't need much to go into, but just to say that Eva and Joy are looking for members of the stewardship team who can help with the new stewardship program. So if you're interested in supporting stewardship and extending your ministry, please see Eva and Joy. At this point, I'm going to ask Deborah, our junior warden and chair of the finance committee, to speak to you about a little bit of what we're looking for in a treasurer.
The systems are in place for us to be compliant with every diocesan report that's required. We just need somebody to step up to be treasurer to oversee what information is going into these systems. We keep track of every penny that's spent, and that has to be assigned to a particular budget line item. Those, when we get back the bank statements, we go through and mark each check with the proper budget line, and those go to a bookkeeper to input. When we receive contributions, those are deposited weekly, and there's checks are copied, and the information is input into a system so that we can give you quarterly statements, and you know how much you've contributed and where you stand with your pledge. It's a very important ministry because we are responsible as a church community for income and expenses. Sometimes things that are budgeted, repairs, property issues, can't be performed because we need the money that we have to pay our ongoing bills, electricity, water, salaries, office supplies. It's a very, very, very important ministry. I'm not going to say it takes no time to do. It does require time. But you've got a team of people who work with you. And you're not alone in this. It's more of an oversight position and making sure that the bills are paid. Having said that, I'm asking you to please pray and ask the Holy Spirit for inspiration, because we really need a treasurer, somebody to assume Carol's responsibility. On a separate note, some of you have questioned why your checks have not been cashed. You've mailed in pledge checks, and they just haven't been cashed. It's not the fault of St. Andrew and Holy Communion. Blame it on the U.S. Postal Service. That's the only thing I can say. I sent a homeowners association payment where I'm living now, in February. I get my statement in March. I'm done $25 for failing to pay on time. May, I get my bill for homeowners. I owe $2 because apparently the check I had written in February somehow finally arrived and got deposited. This isn't the first time this has happened. So rest assured, you don't have to cancel your checks. I think eventually they'll get delivered. If they're not stale, they'll be deposited. If they are stale, we'll ask you for a new one and tell you that we can't deposit it, it's too old. But that it's nothing going on here. The checks are deposited either Sunday in the night depository or Monday every week. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Deborah. And I hope the spirit does nudge you after that motivational call for a new ministry in your heart. It really is a rewarding job. Now, do we have the new Vanco app that's going up? I will not venture into areas of that are not my expertise. Joe has been speaking to this a couple of weeks. The new app is up. If you have any questions or you have any challenges, just reach out to Joe or Carol. They will be happy to help you. Joe is our Vanco and, well, not Vanco anymore, but our mobile giving expert. The lockbox is now in place. I can verify that. I tried it yesterday and it worked well. It's a great piece of technology. I almost wanted to keep opening it all the time, how it works so nicely. A new toy. So if you would like access to it, or if you have any issues with your access, just get in touch with Audie, the parish administrator, on the days that she's here. You should have gotten an email if you have access to the logbox giving you directions, and you can open it right from your phone. You will notice that the prayer list has been condensed. If you have any special prayer that you would like included in the service, please get to email or call the office by Friday morning at 10 a.m. And also be free to share the joys of our prayer, of the results of our prayers when our prayers have been answered. The Barbara Van Doren Welcoming Committee, Reverend Rose speaks to that every week. It will be starting soon. We have Kathy and Eva who will be leading this new Barbara Van Doren Welcoming Committee. Please see Reverend Rose or Kathy and Eva if you would like to be a part of that, or email Reverend Rose. You can also help us to strengthen our outreach ministry. If you want to contribute more and be a part of this effort as we're seeking to expand it, please get in touch with Adrian Prothrow. And the upcoming events, next week, we're back in the parish hall.
Jerry?
For home.
Jerry? On the chat, for the soup kitchen yesterday, there were 150 lunches served from St. Andrew Holy Communion.
So Adrian?
Yes, I'm here. I was waiting for you to finish. Yes, we donated 150 lunches yesterday. And no, I'm not muted.
Kelly, check that speaker.
I see her mic is unmuted. So.
The speaker is on?
I'm not.
It'll be that speaker.
It's good.
On. Yeah.
Technology is great when it works. And today we got positive feedback that everyone at home is hearing us very clearly. So we have one glitch. But Kelly, you were saying we had 150 bag lunches served. Anyone that was at the soup kitchen would like to say something about it? We had a soup kitchen yesterday.
Can you hear me?
Okay, we did serve 150 bag lunches and people were satisfied, happy, and that's a product of our outreach ministry. So I want to thank everyone who contributed, who participated, who made sandwiches, who helped pack, provided whatever service you did to that ministry. That continues to embody our guiding principles and beliefs. So October 10th, homecoming and blessing of the animals. Please feel free to bring your animals in the church. animals will be blessed in the church or after the church outside. So we will be in the parish hall for the first time, in the sanctuary for the first time. All right, we will be in the sanctuary in the church. Thank you. That was to see if you were listening. We will be in the sanctuary next week for the first time, and we will have the blessing of the animals. First time since 2020. Is it 2020? Yeah, feels like 2 years. Yes, except when we were there for confirmation. But that wasn't sack service. it will be us. All right? So you will hear more about the coffee hour. Weather permitting, we'll be outside. And there will be a drive-by blessing of the animals after church, just in case you are not coming to church. You can bring your animals after church to be blessed on the Feast of St. Francis. On October 15, the book club meets at Janice Jones at 5 p.m. Janice?
Yes?
The book club meets at you at 5 p.m.
Yes, that's what I hear. I just need for people to let me know if they're coming so I can make arrangements for proper seating and doodads and, you know, whatever. It'll be fun.
Okay. And we have a rummage sale coming up October 16th and 17th. That should be in about 2 weeks. We're accepting household items, furniture, nothing that absorbs, like clothings, beddings, mattresses, couches, and so on. We will welcome other gifts instead of that to donate to the rummage sale. Thank Nancy Farrell for the work that she's doing on this. And you can drop off your items before church, October 3rd and 10th. That's today and next Sunday. You can drop off your items right at the church. If it's outside of these times, call the church office and make an arrangement with Audie if you have stuff to drop off for the rummage sale. On November 7th, we have All Saints Day and the baptisms. Because of the space constraints, we're going to have some baptisms on November 7th and some baptisms on January 9th. Because, you know, we're limited with the amount of people we can have in the sanctuary, not a parish hall. And on December 5th, we celebrate the independence of Barbados. And on January 16th, we know we have the visitation by the Right Reverend, our Bishop, Carly Hughes, and it's Martin Luther King Day. And today I want us to give a special round of applause for the Nigerian community as we join with them in celebrating Nigerian independence today. So give a round of applause for all the members of our Nigerian community, and we wish them well, success, and let's keep that precious nation state in our prayers. Thank you very much. Any other announcements for the good of the community?
No.
Okay, thank you.
I thought it, you just said it out.
continue with the general thanksgiving found on page 31 and in your Book of Common Prayer, page 101. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life. But above all, for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only in our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Amen. Let them sing. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in church and in Christ Jesus forever and ever. Amen. The Mass has ended. The work in the world begins. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia,
alleluia.
Thank you so much.